Thank you. good afternoon, coffee drinkers. I don't normally start out the vlog with like a massive jam, but I am in total practice mode. I thought it was like the perfect opportunity to give yet another kind of full, complete performance. I had no idea what it was gonna be. You would never guess where it came from. I posted yesterday on Facebook a thing from my buddy Henrik Sundman, guitar player. I was at Berkeley with him, he was a guitar player. We connected on Facebook yesterday for the first time in, I guess, almost 20 years, and he had this beautiful piano piece that he had written, and he was playing, and he posted the video on Facebook, and it was something along the lines of, I had this line cliche. I didn't transcribe it or anything, I just listened to it a few times and the opening stuck out, and then there was like the use of the major seven on a minor chord. And if you know anything a little bit about harmony and you're thinking, well, okay, it was in F, that's in F sharp and it's a minor major sound, how on earth did you end up playing like this G dominant sound, which I was just playing for the last 7 or 8 minutes? Like, how did that come together? Well, that's exactly how it happens, to be inspired initially by one idea that's very kind of a little bit James Bond kind of harmony. Of course, it's not James Bond harmony, it's it's classical sounding harmony, and then the use of that major seven. Well, I started running up to that major seven on the minor chord. Oh God, I love that sound so much. But what I started doing was reharmonizing the top note. Obviously here I'm in minor. Then I would have a different chord as I reach the top note. So that's A flat. We were in F sharp. Now A flat minor 6, G minor 9. I tried all these voicings. Tried all these ideas until I started getting into like way, way different. How. Started getting into those three note voicings, those kind of cluster voicings with half steps and whole steps in them. Pretty out there in terms of the difference between the two chords. And then I kind of left Henrik's idea behind and started off with my own idea. And that's quite often how it happens. I end up practicing and working on something that had pretty much nothing to do with the original idea. And that's kind of how my weird old brain works sometimes. I'm just moving around, like starting off again with that initial idea. There. And the more I work on this, I haven't even tuned, I just sat down and started playing. I haven't even tuned my bass yet. It's probably, yeah, it's way out there. Just starting to hear that. Once you get into a ton of pedals and effects, like the tuning can sometimes get a little bit masked because there's so much modulation going on. That wasn't so bad, but it's bad enough that I need to tune. But yeah, you know, the more I practice this stuff at kind of a relaxed pace and, you know, in the comfort of my own home and in my practice routine and on my time and on my schedule, the more I can start to transform these ideas from really just kind of simple things into compositions, the more I work on these things, the more I find offshoots from the simple ideas, the faster my reaction time is when I'm on the gig, when I'm especially gearing up. I'm leaving in a week from tomorrow. I'm leaving for the first European leg of the Last Minute World Tour, and that's kind of where I want to get my reaction time, you know, clicking and just be, you know, just have my flow and be able to be in the moment and find ideas and search for things in real time. So I take a simple idea like this. It's just F sharp minor major, courtesy of my buddy Henrik. And if you haven't seen that video, go to my Facebook profile and check it out. I posted it on my Facebook page. It's a beautiful piece of piano music. There's a ton more stuff in there that I want to rip off besides just this one chord. Some really nice movements. I think he did that like... I don't think the D was in there, but those kind of classical sounding movements, a lot of that was in his piece. So plenty more mileage and stuff to steal from him. But it's not too overly complicated. I'm not getting too far away from the initial idea, and I am making music. And I think most importantly, bolstering and improving my confidence with that style of playing and with that concept. Because on this tour, you know, I'm slowly getting away from playing older compositions and getting more into improvising new ones on the spot. And just to have that kind of reactive attitude happening, you know, every night, it's gonna be tough every night. I did look at the schedule today and think, oh my God, what have I done? There's a run of 8 nights in a row where I don't have a day off, or maybe even 9 nights or something. So either I'm going to be really exhausted by about night 7 of that particular run, or I'm going to be really on fire, and by night 9, I'm going to be coming up with some great stuff. Either way, I want to be as prepared as I possibly can, so that's basic fundamental practice stuff. That was actually pretty terrible. I do need to slow down and play some basic things, get my fingers kind of back into shape. I haven't been playing that much for the past couple of days, 3 or 4 days. I was away and didn't play over the weekend. So just getting those little things locked in and working as hard as I possibly can on being relaxed, of course, letting things flow and not forcing anything. Like before I turned the camera on, for instance, I did have that loop going, just the basic one. I don't even know if I can remember it now. Three voicings, I had that going, and I was in two minds as to whether to stop that and then start the camera and then re-record the loop, because then it might feel a little bit forced. But I was pretty close to having just come up with that idea, so I figured it would be still be honest and be in the moment. And then I had no idea what I was going to build from that, what percussion I was going to build, what melodies, what arrangement, what parts. So that's generally how I am, but I really am trying not to force things. So there are some times where I get a loop going like that. That's why I wanted to get as much of it as possible in. I get this whole thing going in this soundscape, and then I think, oh man, that would be really good for today's vlog. And by that time, I've built it all up, and I can't show you all the layers, and if I tried to recreate it, it wouldn't really be the same. It wouldn't be as impactful. So that's another thing I'm conscious of in my practice routine, is to not kind of go over stuff too much and to really let each idea be as fresh as possible. So for now, today's vlog is done, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.